Hi, welcome to this video session. So in this video we'll be talking and we'll be seeing a hands-on demo wherein we'll be seeing like how we can use Chrome developer tools to debug a JavaScript code snippets. So let us see like what outcomes have been planned for this video. So at the end of this session, the audience will be able to use debugger feature of Chrome developer tools for debugging JavaScript code snippets. So here, so I'll be using my machine. We'll be using a Chrome developer browser wherein we'll be creating a small use case and we'll be debugging that by inserting few breakpoints and objective of debugging the code. So for this hands-on, what we need is we need a good knowledge of fundamentals of JavaScript language and we need a stable Chrome browser. So let us do this hands-on session. So I'll be switching to Chrome browser and we will be writing some HTML code file and also a JavaScript code. So let us switch to Chrome browser. So into incognito mode and now I'll open the developer tools. So you can follow the screen and my cursor over the screen. You can see that to go to the developer tools, go under the menu called as more tools and under that you have a further menu structure where you will click developer tools. Click on developer tools, then this displays you the console wherein what we are more interested is, we are interested in exploring this sources tab of this. So here I need to load a JavaScript file, the HTML content. So to load it, the best way is to make sure we already have HTML file and script file written and that script file will be opening here in the Chrome browser. So what I'll be doing is in some other directory, I'll create a small folder and within which I'll write my HTML file in JavaScript. So we are within sample and I'll open a command window here. So the best way to create these files is through command prompt. So I'm on the command prompt and I need to go to D drive. Okay, let me go to D drive here. So this is the directory where we have created a program and then let us create a small index.html here. Yes, so let me type the code. So this would even act as a good revision of writing a basic HTML file. So I'm directly writing a body tag and then script will be loading it externally. Or even sometimes it's also possible that we can even have an inline script, even that too isn't a right way of working with JavaScript. But here we would prefer, so I'm taking a small paragraph with ID, say, so let us call, let's name ID as para. So now we have this para ID. I'll close this para tag and I'll have some text here, sample text. Here you can load the script. So I'm loading an external script file. And I'll call this as output.js, wherein it will output numbers from 1 to 10 on the panel. And I want this process to be initiated when I click input on a button. So I'll call type is equal to button. And it's on click. On click of this, I'll be triggering here. So I'm thinking like we'll write a method in output.js, which will have a method called as print numbers. So this is a method which we'll be triggering on calling an input. Now we have this index file. Let's also create the script file here. Our file was output.js. Here I can write this function here. Well, I'll directly write the function. The function which we thought was print numbers. So let me copy it just to avoid some name related errors here. Print numbers, it would be void. And what it would do is it would get that element document dot get element by ID. So what ID we gave to paragraph tag para dot will set it text inner. Okay, so it's panel, we'll use inner HTML and we'll write a for loop here because I wanted to generate numbers from 1 to 10. So I'll call this as where I, or we can even prefer to have int I. Then 10, and I'll call it I plus plus. And every time a loop executes in its execution, I'm gonna take a small variable called as text plus equal to. I'll convert the number so that it will be I plus. I'll append a br tag so that I can see the output one after line by line. Okay, so let me indent it for you. So the code looks fine here, and then after this I'm setting that value here. So let us see and let us execute if it works fine. Which we did was like, now is not closed. So now you can see that we have a proper script tag. So sometimes it helps me, like when I was able to open the console in Chrome developer tools, I was able to explore this element tag structure where I was able to see that, like, the issue was that I had a script tag wasn't closed here. So entire all the HTML content was everything into a script tag, and so it was not able to appear on the browser output. So now what we have done is we need to name this number. We'll give a proper name. Okay, rather than name, we'll give it the value, which will be the text of that button. Okay, so now you can see that if I do this, here it is. Now I'll go to console. If there's any problem here, okay, I have a error, so like print numbers is not defined. So we need to open, like, is print numbers defined? Yes. And see, here is an actual error. What we are doing is we are using a Chrome developer tools to debug the JavaScript. So I have an error here. And if I want to explore what exactly is the error, where exactly is the error, go to the source tab, which automatically loads all the script files associated with this web page. So here, when I click on output.js, it shows me error here. So you can see uncaught syntax error identifier expected. We did not give I, I think. This fine. Type instance, JavaScript is type insensitive. So let me reload this. Okay, and after reloading, now I have error uncaught unexpected. So maybe I might have not closed the brackets properly. Okay, so this is what we kept the output.js incomplete. So let us complete output.js. So once a loop executes, it's calculating a string, and this string will be the text of that para. So I need to just assign the text to this here. So now you can see, if I load this, and I don't have any script errors at least, so syntactically my code is fine. So now I can click on click. So if I click, now the print numbers is executed. So after clicking on this, so the print numbers method has been called, but still we have a few errors here. So what do these exact errors define? So I'll go to source. Okay, what it says, okay, unexpected text is not defined. Yes. So we are deliberately doing this because we expect the audience to actually learn, like, what all goes wrong when you start executing this code. So we'll just define where text is equal to some just a blank string. So save it and reload it once again. So if I click now you can see that it displays numbers from 0 to 9. Now, if I want to debug that, so we were more talking about, like, what exactly happens when we click on that breakpoint. I need to see a breakpoint while execution. So when I want to see a breakpoint while execution, for example, at line number 4, I want to see if the I value is being incremented or not. So now I want to insert a breakpoint. So right now, you can see here the watch window, the call stack, and it says that we do not have any breakpoints. So for a proper and a very careful debugging, we need to insert a breakpoint. So let us insert a breakpoint at line number 4. Okay, so if you want to insert a breakpoint, just click on that. It just inserts a breakpoint. The moment I have clicked on this the point where I am hovering my cursor, the moment I click on that, it's a breakpoint has been inserted. If I click once again, the breakpoint has been removed. So I want a breakpoint at this. Once I have a breakpoint, then I have this breakpoint executed. So under watch, we do not have any watch variables, but here now I want to see what value the variable I at line number 4 is assuming. So I'll add 8, and right now it is 10. because my code has already executed, I'll add one more watch variable and I want to see what value the text is having. So I'm entering text and hit enter, it just adds the text. Looks like it took this one. This is not, I don't want this one, but I want a built-in variable. So it's text. So if you don't want auto completion, just hit one. So right now the text is not available. It would be only available upon execution, this line number 4. Now I want to repeat this once again. So what I'll do is just so let's also run that. So now you can click on here and let me run this code, evaluate in console. Okay, it's now executing that. And now you can step into this. For example, I will have it for, okay. So let me execute this by clicking on this button once again. So what I'm doing, I'm clicking on this once again. Script is execute. And my execution stopped at line number 4 because I have inserted breakpoint at line number 4. So now the line has paused there and you can see if this line executes, I is value 0 and text value is null, a blank string. So now we have a few options like what all, my execution is paused at moment. Now what all steps I need to do further? The few steps I had sold, I have a step over and I have step into and I have a step out of current function and step. Step is nothing but it moves to the next line so that the sequence moves on and executing. Now, as we all know, the standard definition of step over is that, I have step into and step out. I'll first let you know what is step into. So the line which right now the breakpoint is working on, had there been a function call at that line, and if I click on step into, the debugging control would actually start debugging the function code. And the moment I'm into that function code and the latter, you might feel that I don't want to debug the code and I want to come back and I want to execute my normal code which has called the function, then you will be clicking on step out. So step into step out are ways they decide whether you want to debug the functions deep or you'll decide a stage at where you want to come out. And if you click on to step over, what it executes is, if it's a single line, it just executes it. And if there is a function call at the breakpoint, and if you click on step over, it just executes the function and it replaces what is the value function, return value, whatsoever the method signature is, and it just moves to the next breakpoint. So right now we do not have any breakpoints, we do not have any function calls at the breakpoint. So I'll just simply go to step F9. So if I click on F9, the execution moves to line by line execution. Okay, so now you can see the value of this is changed, 0 and BR. I'll click once again. Okay, the I value is 1 because the loop is executing now. So the second one, third, you can see that value is incrementing. Please observe this, the one where I'm moving cursor. The values are automatically changing here. So this is how, like, I wanted to show you that you can even use the Chrome browser's built-in developer tools to debug your JavaScript code. So you might have a question like, why don't we use a track? Because see here, when we start debugging a lot of web pages, it's always better to debug them in a browser because end people will be at the end, they will be watching your, they will be browsing your website in their Chrome browsers. IDEs always have a different run times. So it's as a good practice for a web developer, it's quite crucial for him to debug his script issues directly in a browser. So we'll just complete it by clicking on till I come out of this loop. So it's 7, 8, 9. So this loop, you can see that the text value is changing and it also displays what value the text, the variable text is having right now. Okay, so I've done. So once I'm done, I'm back to this and you can see that debugger has completed execution. So you can see that you can click on this and you'll get the value here, 0, 1, 2, 3, all 9. As a quick summary in a nutshell, what have we seen? We have seen how do we write an HTML code and how do we attach a script. We have seen when script and HTML content doesn't work, like how we can debug it with the help of using Chrome developer tools and the console output and the sources tab of Chrome developer tabs. And we also seen how we insert a breakpoints and how we can add watch variables and how we can meticulously watch how my code is executing with the help of carefully chosen breakpoints. So as a question for you, what do you think, like, does watch window let you change the value of a variable? So we didn't see, like, you can, since this has been a hands-on video, if you have been following me my actions in a video on your browser, you can quickly do the change and you can find out if I can change the value inside watch window or not. But see, the most of debuggers, what they do, they always lets you change the values in the watch window. So this is it for this video. And as a further reading, I would suggest you refer the link, which I'm right now, it's been shown on your screen. This standard developer documentation where Google has listed off out how we can debug JavaScript and additional features of Chrome developer tools. So this is the bibliography, and I would advise, if required, you can directly start with the JavaScript samples on W3 schools instead of my way of approach, where I preferred writing code and debugging everything in front of you. So this is it, and thanks for watching this.